Here we are at this socket. Now I've just done an R1, R2 check on it with the figure of eight check, so the continuity check. And on this socket I got about 79 ohms or something like that, whereas all the other sockets throughout the house was reading about 0.24 ohms. So there was this socket that was reading high, and then the socket on the other side of the wall. So everything's live again now, and so just with my socket tester, and you can see that the socket is turned off and it's flashing all red lights. Now I hadn't actually seen that previously because I just turned it on, so this is actually turned off and it's saying that there's a live fault. But now if I turn the switch on, it now comes up as to say, so two red lights and a green light, and that says there's that live to neutral reverse, which is a bit of a problem. I've never had that before like this. I'm just scraping around the outsides there because it's been freshly painted recently. So I just want to undo it exactly how it is. These screws are a bit awkward. So this is the first time I've undone it. This house has recently been refurbished, and all I'm doing is an EICR for the people who are renting the property out. But it has just apparently it's undergone a full rewire and a new consumer unit and nothing, but there's no records of anything. So I'm just gently gonna prise this open. I don't know what we can see on here. So we've got the neutrals, or what appears to be the neutrals, and they are going into the live terminal. And then the neutral down this side, the red wires are going in that. So that appears that we have a live and neutral reverse. So obviously I'm gonna have to fix that. I can't just leave that like it is. Couple other things on here that you can see. There's no grommets, and you can see this is a relatively new box. It's again, this one's just been fitted in the last sort of 6 weeks, I think. Or this is one that has been done, and you can see there's no grommets on there. There's no grommets by the looks of on this side neither. So I'll put this one back together, and then we'll quickly have a look at the other one. Oh, in fact, if you look at that, I've just noticed that's wobbly as well. Let's just see how tight the screw is. But let's just see how tight that is. If I can get it on. Yeah, look at that. That's not tight at all. So that will need doing and fixing, putting right. Okay, so now I've rewired this 13 amp socket. I've put the same socket back on. It's actually a brand new socket, even though it's a very cheap one. But we've reused it. So you can see that we've put the lines back in their correct place, we've put the neutrals back in their correct place. We've put grommets on the 20mm cutouts because they didn't have them on. I haven't put washers on the screws. That's how I would install them with washers, but we haven't done it this time. And I haven't neatened up in fact I will just trim that bit off. I should have done that. But one of the things that I have done here is I've took both of the CPCs into the into this brass terminal there, and then I've just took the fly lead coming out and going straight into the connection there, rather than just extending them and putting the fly lead in anyway. I've just done it like that. I haven't doubled back the live conductors how I'd normally do them. For one, there wasn't a lot of space in the terminals, and two, there's these two wires coming from the bottom. There's not a lot of length on them, so I could have extended them, but I haven't done I haven't done that. So anyway, that's hopefully that's a neater job. We'll go and do the other side now, and then we can get it tested and check that it's all okay. So we're now at the back of the socket that we've just shown you. So this is in the room adjacent. So again, I'm just gonna, and again, I've got a bad reading on this one. So that says this time, all three red lights are flashing, which shows a live fault. Turn it on, and then it says, again, the same fault previously. I think that's the same fault previously. Yep, live neutral reverse. I want to show you exactly what's going on as I'm seeing it. So from an inspector's point of view, and again, this one as well has apparently just been replaced. I think this is original. This is an original socket. I'm not really sure. But again, exactly the same thing in this situation here. So if you look there, again, the neutrals are just twisted up and go into here, into the live and the line, the reds go into the neutral. And again, there's no earth tail coming back to the box, no grommets. Even silly little, even things like the screws, they should really have a washer on there. It's just quite poor workmanship. So we're now back at the original socket. I've connected the figure of eight stage three test up again. And so now we can check it. So the figure of eight is obviously between the line and the CPCs. And so I've turned it onto the low reading no meter, turn it on. I've already zeroed out these leads. 0.27, that's a good reading. That's what we were getting on all the other sockets. And now if we just go round to the other socket, you see I've done this one as well. Again, plug it in. And this is the first time I've tested it. Turn it on, 0.27. So that's a good reading again. So now I'll go and reconnect it back up, and then we'll do a live check again. Okay, so this is the circuit that I'm working in. So I always write down everything before I write the certificate. It always gets filled out on my pad first. So this socket here is this socket. So you can say when I got the reading, I was getting 80.7 ohms. And again, the socket on the other side was this one. So now I can get rid of both of those because I knew that those ones were faulty. So it was 0.27. So in total, 13 sockets plus the two. So 15 sockets on that one circuit that I've found so far. That's just how we do those ones. So now we can plug this back in. All good. Again, I'm only using the plug-in tester just as a means of quick testing, just to check. It's not actually part of any official checking. So, or any official testing. So now I've set the, while I'm here, I may as well do a ZS test. And so let's turn that on. It's picked up a voltage. Always takes a few seconds. 0.98 things. So, I've got ZS, so 0.98 for that one. I'll then go round and check all the others. So we can turn this one off. Now, one thing you will notice underneath is as soon as I started taking it apart, part of this just kept breaking away. Now I've got some of the polyfiller in the van, so before I do go, I will just polyfiller that up and just let the client know that I've done that. Let's go back round to the other socket. This was the first socket that we came, that we did, that I videoed. So again, plug it in, it was showing live and neutral reverse. Now it's showing everything's good. So again, we may as well do a ZS test on this one as well. It's picked up a voltage. One ohms. So again, I've now made a note of that. So again, how I did this one with all these figures here for my R1 R2 will be the highest out of those readings. Same with this one. I'll go around now and check the ZS for each one of those and go from there. So just to end the video, one of the things that we're taught when we're doing EICR, which is what I'm doing today, is that we're here just to check the actual condition of the circuits and not actually take everything apart and fix them. You make a list of all your C1, C2, C3s, and then you go from there. But sometimes you get situations like today that you can't. I don't think you can just leave it. It's easier to fix it, spend another sort of half hour fixing it rather than just leaving it, especially in the other room that you saw. There was a cot in that room, so that's actually a little nursery where there's a little 2-year-old child lives in there. So you can't leave, in my opinion, you can't leave the sockets with a fault like that in it. So yes, it has took me an extra half hour to fix the job. Hopefully I'll be able to charge a little bit extra to the landlord. I've already phoned the landlord up and explained this, and they already know how we do things anyway, because I've done lots of jobs for them before. Just a quick one. In both rooms, they have got these little fans in them, and the customer has informed me just afterwards that they have had problems with both of these working. So they've got one on this socket and one on the other socket, and so they are intermittently working. So they've only just told me that after I found the fault anyway. Now, if every single socket had the same fault, obviously I wouldn't have gone round and done all the and fixed everything like this. I'd have had to have put it on hold and said to the landlord that we need to come back on another day. But seeing as you can see on my results that I'm getting on here, 13 out of the 15 sockets were all good. It's only the last two that I tested that weren't good, and so that's why I fixed them. So now that circuit is a good circuit. I dread to think what all the other sockets have been wired up like. As I said, I've been told it's a full rewire and stuff, but it doesn't look like it was a full rewire, because we've still got the old red and the black cables in there. But anyway, that's just a quick insight into doing the continuity testing on a ring final circuit and showing some of the faults that there are that you can come across.